Assalamu alaikum. Pigs and dogs are not permissible to consume for Muslims. So, does that mean we can be unkind to the pigs and the dogs? No. We should be very kind to all living creatures. في كل كبد رطبة أجر. There is a reward in everything that is living, everything that has a liver. Subhanallah. MashaAllah. My brothers and sisters, many people think that because pigs are prohibited to consume, we're allowed to throw stones at the pigs, we're allowed to actually abuse these pigs. That's not true. Be they pigs or dogs or cats or whatever else it may be. There is a narration of the Prophet ﷺ wherein he speaks about someone who was kind to a dog and earned the forgiveness of Allah as a result. Why was a dog mentioned? Although dogs are not permissible to consume, and there are certain restrictions when it comes to our relation with a dog. But at the same time, it was the case in order to prove to us that we should never be unkind to any animal, no matter what it is. In fact, even if it comes to lions and snakes and whatever else it may be, you cannot be unkind to these animals. A harmful animal that's coming for you or that is on the line of harm, you may want to kill that animal or that creature if it is harmful. Say, for example, a snake. If it's going to harm you, you may kill it, but you cannot torture it. You must try to kill it in the quickest possible way. That's what it is. Subhanallah, if you're in the line of harm, but you don't go around to the natural habitats of these animals and start singling them out and torturing them, harming them. The same applies to rodents and rats. Sometimes we have rodents in houses, and sometimes we have certain insects and cockroaches and creatures and so on. Don't torture them. That's the bottom line. We're taught not to torture. Some people torture the rats. I remember a young kid who used to put these rats in milk bottles and electrocute them and get joy by seeing these rats being sizzled by electricity a little by little. That's not good. That is prohibited. It is also a creature. Yes, you want to get rid of it? Get rid of it quickly. A quick one. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. I thought it would be important to talk about this topic where we're not allowed to be unkind to any creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those that are harmful, those that are not harmful. Those that are within what we can consume and those that are not within that. Remember, this advice is golden. And if you're not allowed to be harming any creature, remember, the humankind is right at the top of that list. So for you to harm a fellow human being, ooh, the price is payable in hard cash. Subhanallah. The price is payable in something really severe. So don't mess with other human beings as well. Be kind to one another. That's the advice of the Prophet ﷺ. Subhanallah. We're even taught not to call each other bad names. We're taught, the Quran clearly says, لا تنابزوا بالألقاب. Don't call each other names that are disliked by the other. Don't use titles that are derogatory, because it will hurt people. If hurting people, abstaining from it, goes to this level, then imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. May Allah forgive us all and make us from those who care for all the creatures of Allah. And like I said, if you truly have to get rid of an animal or a creature or an insect, let's do it in the best way possible, the quickest way possible, without torturing these animals unnecessarily. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.